While chairing today's afternoon parliament sitting, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, expressed concerns with the grave misconduct of members of parliament who are reportedly involved in soliciting bribes while executing their mandate.
And I hope they received the letters. I've written to all the whips to ensure that they instill some discipline in some of the members that are mentioned. I am not saying all of you are mentioned.
Among noted that she has already written to all political party whips in the House, directing them to reign over their members who are tainting the image of the institution. The Speaker also directed the Clerk to Parliament to establish a desk to handle complaints from members of the public for prompt redress.
And you know, this would destroy the reputation of 11th Parliament. The responsibility of guarding this institution is on you and me. If we don't guard it, then we will not have a good institution. So it is upon us to ensure that we respect ourselves, we respect the institution, we preserve the name of the institution.
Several legislators condemned the practice and called for tough sanctions against the implicated legislators.
I think it's something very open. This is corruption, which we have been talking about. If there is any official or any member of parliament that will be trying to use their position to get money from the accounting officers in a manner that is not really legal, I think this is really very, very unfortunate. And personally, I condemn it. And I think the Speaker was very right to re-echo again to the party whips.
However, the chairperson of the Parliamentary Forum on Ethics and Integrity, James Nsababuturo, said the syndicated approach makes it difficult to fight corruption.
Where we are now, we've reached a point where those that are mandated to be doing something are also in the game of stealing, of ravaging this nation's prospects for change. It's a very complex situation.
In the 10th Parliament, the Speaker of Parliament then, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, disbanded the Trade Committee over corruption allegations during the processing of the sugar bill. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.